Claiborne, the author of Green is for Life, a simple guide to creating healthy, life-giving green smoothies. Well, this is life after a green smoothie fast, or this is life with incorporating a daily green smoothie into your life. I'm going to be talking today about quinoa. Queen of the Wa. Last week, I showed you how to make a quinoa salad and also how to cook and prepare quinoa and then how to make a quinoa salad. This week, I'm going to be showing you how to make a portabella mushroom stir-fried quinoa. Guys, it is bon appétit. It's one of those moments. I'm going to be telling you what my secret ingredients are. I'm going to give those up to you. My secret ingredients are that give it that je ne sais quoi. That je ne sais quoi. And you know, guys, I'm all for make up your own je ne sais quoi. You know, when you get the basics, you play around and do what it is that works for you and your family. So anyway, I'm going to get started. I'm going to be using my coconut oil to stir fry with. I've got pepper. I've got pepper. I have my Himalayan salt, or you use sea salt, Celtic salt, whatever you call it. Okay. I have, this is 2 large portabella mushrooms. They're washed, dried, sliced, and cut into fairly big chunks. Okay, all right. Some people believe that, you know, with mushrooms, that you should just actually wipe them off with a damp cloth. I've never understood that reasoning, given that mushrooms have dirt on them. I mean, how would you like to be just wiped off all the time? So no, I believe that you should actually wash them and wash the dirt off, unless you actually know the soil, unless you've actually planted the mushrooms yourself. Other than that, I believe you should wash them. You wash them, you dry them very, very well, they'll be good to go. Okay, let's see, show you what else I've got. Okay, remember we made our own teriyaki sauce? Well, I ran out, and I actually thought I had loads and loads, but I didn't. So what I did today was I used soy sauce and vegetarian oyster sauce, which again is made from oyster mushrooms. So I've got oyster sauce in here, I've got soy sauce, and I have a teaspoon of agave, because I actually want it to mimic teriyaki sauce. So you can use teriyaki sauce in this recipe, you can use soy sauce in this recipe, or you can use what I just used, which was a mixture to give me more of the flavor of a teriyaki sauce. But typically, if you have some of the teriyaki sauce that we made, you would use the teriyaki sauce that we made. Okay, you're also going to need eggs, and of course I have organic, somebody's nicely raised chicken eggs here, or you can leave it out. Anything that you don't want, you can leave out, it's optional. Okay, I'm gonna talk about my secret ingredients in just a moment. Okay, we're gonna have some black beans, and that's half a cup of black beans. Okay, I have 2 teaspoons of ginger, minced ginger. I have 1.5 cups of diced onions. I have 1.5 cups of mixed vegetables. All right. I have 2 teaspoons of garlic. I've got 2 teaspoons of garlic. It's my garlic and my ginger. And then on my cutting board, I have spring onions, red capsicums or bell peppers. That's from the garlic. I've got cherry tomatoes, celery, two sticks of celery, half a large capsicum, red capsicum. This is three spring onions. This is, I think this was eight cherry tomatoes, two sticks of celery, and of course, you know me, I like my my chilies. I've got Serrano, so that's two Serranos chopped, or should I say sliced, no seeds, they're sliced. And of course, I've got a couple of tablespoons of cilantro, and I do have one of my secret ingredients, which is basil, and that comes from my garden, okay? So these are all the ingredients. Now, the other secret ingredients that we will be using, you know I'm a wino, okay, is masala. Now, masala, we're going to use the masala when we actually cook the mushrooms. Masala is key in this recipe. If you don't drink alcohol and you don't like alcohol, what I would say to you then is to use rice wine vinegar. You see the wine's still in there somewhere. I would use rice wine vinegar. I've never tried it with apple cider, but this is key to the recipe, guys. It's key. I've made it without and I've made it with, and this brings, it's like the je ne sais quoi. It really does bring something to the equation, okay? So that's masala. And people will interchange masala with sherry. In this instance, if you use sherry, like cream sherry, it's too full-bodied. It will take over the recipe. My other secret ingredient is five spices. Chinese or Oriental. It's actually Chinese, five spices. Now, this is key. Also key, this is the je ne sais quoi. This is what makes it different. These two ingredients, or should I say these three ingredients, is what makes it different. These three ingredients. The masala, the basil, and the five spices. And with the five spices, you only need an eighth of a teaspoon. You don't need a lot because it will totally take over. Talk about a bossy in-law or a bossy relative or a bossy sister or brother. It will take over. So you only need an eighth of a teaspoon, but that's all you need. You want to hit, you just want those flavors. What you want are those different layers, those different flavors. And that's what you're looking for. So I tell you what, guys, we're going to set up.
Okay, guys,
in my pan, I have 3 tablespoons of coconut oil. And to that, I'm going to add all the onions because we're just going to kind of soften the onions down first. All right, so we're going to saute the onions up. And we're going to get those going. And then we're going to add to it. We're going to add the garlic. Okay, our onions are starting to brown ever so slightly. So I'm going to add our ginger. I'm going to add the ginger. About 2 teaspoons of ginger. That smells nice and fragrant. And see, it's starting to brown. And that's what you're looking for. That's okay. That adds to the flavor. That adds to the flavor. I'm going to add the garlic. Smells really good. Right, I'm going to turn it down ever so slightly. Because in this instance, because sometimes you can brown garlic. You know, I know there's a lot of recipes, they're like, no, don't let the garlic get brown. But in some instances, browning the garlic brings the food to a whole nother layer. I mean, and those are some of the dishes that I'm going to show you. Those tend to be more Thai, in like Thai style dishes. That kind of cuisine. Alright, guys. And so, bearing in mind that I am using soy sauce, and oyster sauce, vegetarian oyster sauce. I'm just going to hit this with just a little bit of sea salt, and I'm going to hit it with just a little bit of pepper. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this out, and then I'm going to cook the mushrooms.
Okay guys, we're going to add the mushrooms,
and we are going to literally brown the mushrooms, okay? They're going to be a golden brown. By the time we've finished, they'll be a nice golden brown.
And okay that's guys, as you can see, the portobello mushrooms are turning this golden colour, and that's what you want. That adds lots of flavour.
Well, you're going to add 1/8 teaspoon, and I'm going to eyeball it because I actually want it fairly nicely distributed. All right, and that's about 1/8 teaspoon that went in. Oh, that smells really lovely. Let me turn that down. That really smells nice. Nice and fragrant. Nice and fragrant. And then from there, you need 2 tablespoons of your masala, and 1 teaspoon for luck, okay? And then you're going to allow that to literally do its thing, and i.e. it's going to actually evaporate, it's going to boil down.
Okay guys,
and as you can see, the masala wine has evaporated out, and what that will leave is nothing but flavor. Okay, we are going to start this process now, and to this we're going to actually add our celery, which I had in the middle, which was really crazy of my board, but not to worry. We're going to add our celery. This is only going to take a few minutes to cook, because what you want is the vegetables to remain very, very crunchy. This is really part of the process. We want the vegetables to remain crunchy. Okay, so we're going to add that. Celery. All right. Get that nice little mix. And it's really funny. Well, I say it's really funny, but you can smell the different, you know, like the different spices and everything as it comes together. We are going to put back into the pan our sautéed mushrooms with our brown garlic. And earlier I said, you know, we weren't, well, we did brown the garlic, let's put it this way. Okay, so that's that. Oh, yeah. That works. Right, I'm gonna turn the fire up just a tad. Make sure that's heated through. Okay guys, and I'm turning the fire up just a tad. And now I'm gonna add our quinoa. And that was 4 cups of quinoa. Add my black beans. I'm going to add my black beans, and again just keep mixing them, and you start seeing how it builds and the colour, the colours, because for the most part everything has been cooked through for the most part. And then now I'm going to add you can add your teriyaki sauce, your soy sauce at this juncture. You add that. And again, you're on medium high heat. You're on medium high heat. Make sure everything is incorporated well. Make sure it's all incorporated well.
All right, guys, I'm going to do this way. So I'm going to ask my videographer if he has a good shot of the pan, inside the pan. And I got the thumbs up. For your egg, I'm just going to cook the egg straight in the pan. Okay, guys, I'm going to cook the egg straight in the pan. I'm going to hit it with a little bit of salt. So when you bite into it, okay, salt and pepper, and I'm going to scramble him right in the pan. That's one less thing you have to clean. Alright, guys, and this is how this is done. Turn the heat up just a little bit, and then we incorporate it. Just like that. Just like that. Make sure it's all mixed up. Turn it down just a tad. Right, I'm gonna add me veggies. We mix the veggies. We mix the veggies. Now, doesn't that just look like fried rice? Stir fry. Okay, guys, one of the keys to making sure that your vegetable, your capsicums, your red peppers, and your tomatoes and your spring onions and your cilantro actually don't get all wilted up and die in your pot is to turn the heat off and to add them, turn it, and then you can cover the pot. I'm actually not going to cover my pot today. Secret ingredient is gone in as well, and I'm gonna mix that all up. I can even smell it as the heat's hit it. You know, it becomes really fragrant. We're just gonna stir that. See how it brings color to it? See how it brings beautiful color to it? Alrighty. See, because you don't want them all wilted and turn all stringy. My videographer said it smells really good. And then the last thing that I'm going to add are the tomatoes and the scallion, or the green pepper. The green onion. Just give it a little toss. Mix up. Make sure it's evenly distributed. And that, my darlings, is Marsala Portabella Mushroom Stir Fried Quinoa. This is
okay, guys.
It. Well, we're done, and as you can see, or as you saw, we've made our mushroom quinoa, stir fried mushroom quinoa, and this is the dish. With black beans, it's got vegetables, it's got alcohol, it's got vegetables, it's got alcohol, it's got all sorts of stuff. Chinese five spice is the actual, or one of the secret ingredients, along with masala. Again, if you don't like masala, you can definitely use rice wine vinegar. If you don't like rice wine vinegar, you can use vegetable stock and or chicken stock. I mean, you can play around with this. This is a lovely filling meal, used as a main meal or as a side dish. but it's really delicious, and I'm getting ready to try it right now. So guys, this is for you. Mushroom stir-fried quinoa with five spice and masala wine. So I'm getting ready to taste it. We're gonna have the bon appetit, let's eat moment. Let me see. And as I always say, if it's bad, you'll never know, because I'll just keep eating. Or we'll have to cut it out. But anyway, this is it. Actually, it's really good. This is really, really good. That's on point. You got the crunchiness of the celery. You can taste the five spices through it. It's a hint. There's something going on with the masala. You don't really know what it is. It gives it that je ne sais quoi. You get the hint of the basil. A little bit of heat from the Serrano. And then the vegetables. It's just on point. This is, guys, because I'm getting ready to eat. Bon appetit. Let's eat. Stir-fried quinoa with mushrooms, masala, and five spices for you. Until next time, I'm Dr. Wendy Dearborn. Let's eat.